You'll never believe this app that I discovered. It's called in3D, and it makes it extremely easy to scan yourself and your face and create a 3D model that looks hyper-realistic and game-ready, so you can go ahead and export it to an FBX file. So if you're like me and you use Blender and Unity, then it's perfect for that. You can also export it to Character Creator. Here's what the app looks like and some examples of the animations and features that you can find just right within the app. There's all different kinds of clothing. You can do up to 5 scans with the $20 subscription. This is just how easy it is to scan your face. You literally just look left and right and up and down, and then take a picture of your face. Okay, next you just have to turn around and try to make sure that you have good lighting and stuff.
Perfect. When the countdown begins, turn around 3, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
It's easy to retake the scan if you don't like the first attempt. So after a few minutes of processing, you can immediately see your awesome scan and see it with the different animations and try on the different clothes. Okay, not only that, but then you can go into AR mode and put your scan into any environment. So this is pretty fun, and I can imagine it'd be like a fun party trick with your friends or family. It was definitely kind of like Uncanny Valley styles, because I was looking at a life-size version of myself in AR. You could totally use this to make some filters for like Instagram or TikTok. By the way, I wanted to point out ChatGPT-3, if you haven't already looked at it. I'm going to use it for the title of this video. Over on the in3D website, you can see which softwares it's compatible with. You can export a regular FBX.
Avatar with blend shapes, avatar with body rig, or Character Creator 4, or Unreal 5. Those are all the engines you can export it for. It's like seeing these little movies and stuff. Alright, now that we have scanned ourselves, let's get that model into our computer and check it out and see what it looks like. Alright, so after you export those FBXs from the app, then you can open them on your computer by unzipping the files. And first, I decided to try opening the FBX inside of Blender. So I opened up Blender and deleted my default cube.
imported my model and turned on render mode so I could see what the materials looked like. And definitely creepy, but you can see just how easy it could be to sculpt and modify your model. You could actually hand paint the texture to change your outfit in Blender, or use Photoshop to edit the texture. Okay, next I decided to import the FBX into Mixamo, which is a free software online, and you can upload your FBX and then try out these different animations and download the ones that you like. Since I'm using Unity, when I go to export from Mixamo, I just make sure that Unity is selected. I really like the ones that do flips and acrobatics and different things that I couldn't actually ever do in real life. Last but not least, I wanted to point out that you can also use in3D models with Character Creator and iClone. And these are Reillusion softwares, which are kind of expensive, but you can use the free versions. You can get a whole month or something like that for free. So right now I'm still using the free trial of these Reillusion products. So you can see just how awesome your character can look inside of Reillusion, and you can get it looking as much like yourself as possible, or even better, like an enhanced version. I kind of gave my girls some awesome makeup and really cool hair. There's a default base mesh in Character Creator, and that's what we use. And that's how they integrate it with the app. It kind of just matches the face mesh to match your scan. After you're done customizing your Character Creator character, then you can export it into iClone. And that's where I got these like facial animations. And then after that, you can export it and save it. Just make sure that you check all your settings and that they're how you need them. And then what I did was I created a new Unity project, an HDRP Unity project. And there's these like special Unity tools that make it easy to work with your character creator character. Just wanted to give you a quick preview of what it looks like in Unity, and you can definitely keep me posted if you learn anything new about how to use the in3D model with any of your projects. So I hope you enjoyed this video, friends, and I'll talk to you next time. Thank you very much for your viewership, and special shout out to our Patreon supporters and Twitch subscribers. Talk to you soon, friends. Bye.